Thank you. heart is sad and lonely. For you I sigh, for you, dear, only. Why haven't you seen it? I'm all for you, body and soul. I spend my days in longing and wondering why it's me you're wronging. I tell you, I'm all for you, body and soul. I can't believe it, it's hard to conceive it, that you turn away. Are you pretending it looks like the ending? Unless I could have one more chance to prove, dear, my life a wreck you're making. Surrender myself to you, body and soul.
Anchored by a photographic practice, my artwork is steeped in a personal and global obsession to record things visually. Universally, humans are hungry to capture each moment. This need has grown into an obsession with each additional social media platform that is introduced. Part of me views it as a hoarding behavior, a need to capture every moment and save it forever. Having grown up in an era where photography was analog and not all pictures developed clearly, I am fascinated by how digital photography allows us to have evidence of so many things. But I wonder how well these digital photographs and videos represent what actually occurred. Will our memories be clearer because of this documentation? Do we only need a snippet of a moving or still image to bring events back? Can the documentation accurately represent our emotions and sensations? My work explores the intersection of place and experience and questions the fugitive nature of personal history and memory. The imagery emphasizes the beauty of the mundane in my life and every life. There is a repetitive nature to the work, which expresses how my mind processes the experiences and memories over and over again. I have worked with the theme of memory for over a decade. The idea has manifested itself in a variety of forms, from prints to handmade collages, digital images, and traditional photographs. Unlike my past work, with this series, I wanted to alter the photographs so that they were abstract while still offering small glimpses of recognizable things. In some pieces, multiple photographs are combined, and in others, a single image is repeated. To me, this represents how a mind can alter a memory. Sometimes we confuse or combine multiple experiences, and other times we can only see a partial experience in our mind's eye, and no matter how many times we repeat the image, it never becomes complete. My training is in printmaking, which is an extremely process-oriented medium. This is one of the reasons I was so drawn to it. I carry that mentality into all aspects of my art-making practice, thinking in layers and steps when building an image. Each of these five artworks were physically created through a painstaking process of hand cutting and reassembling. Some of the surfaces were disrupted through methodical tearing and mark making. I chose to not create these digitally because the repetitive handworking of materials became very meditative and, for me, enhanced the overall experience of making them. Even when working with traditional photographs or digital images, there is some process that I rely on, whether building an installation of multiple prints or layering one image upon another. These five pieces are part of a larger series that I began at an artist residency I attended in 2018.
Thank you. My name is Dragana Cerniak. I'm Associate Professor of Art and Foundations Coordinator at Youngstown State University. I work primarily in drawing, painting, and site-specific installation. My work overall has always been triggered by these two opposite forces in my head, memory and anticipation. And what I mean by memory is my fascination with the ways we remember and carry fragments of memories with us, how certain experiences and memories establish themselves as important for our identities. Then anticipation relates to the immediacy of working with materials and images, and driven by this continuous longing for new clarity, new discoveries, questioning of the familiar, and embracing of unpredictable. In site-specific work, the specific architectural features of a given gallery space shape the work, and the unique ways a viewer enters and experiences the image within the space. I'm interested in the perceptual shifts and the ways we perceive the visual information within the given space and the context of a museum or a gallery. The wall drawing unfolding is a charcoal drawing exploring perception as a process existing between sensing and perceiving, knowing and anticipating. The density and softness of charcoal as its primary medium was essential to emphasize both its boldness and the sense of instability. Currently, I'm working on small-scale drawings, which is new to me. These small drawings measure 10 by 10 inches and are completed on wooden gessoed panels with charcoal. What is very exciting to me at this point is that I can work through many different images and ideas quickly and accumulate the work, which now as a body of work appears to be a sort of cartography of my thinking. The work truly is diagramming the subtle changes, discoveries, memories, questions that occupy me daily. Some of the drawings are based on domestic and familiar patterns I grew up around, but I was mainly interested in the subtle ways these small domestic elements can appear as transforming into landscapes, shifting from the intimate and personal into these new fabricated spaces, becoming sort of mental landscapes. I wanted them to have both documentary realistic look while appearing dreamlike at the same time. On one hand, I like to restrict myself and keep the choice of materials to a minimum, while testing and pushing the wide exploration of surfaces and processes in the studio. Image field 4 is a digitally manipulated pattern developed from a collected embroidery. It appears as if it's falling apart or coming together slowly. I'm drawn to the softness and the handmade imperfections that charcoal on the wood panel usually brings. The tension between organic, loose, and the geometric controlled imagery. With a goal to have 25 to 30 drawings completed and displayed in a long line, I am working on developing a specific kind of viewing experience that will have a cinematic quality. As a viewer moves from the first to second, third, and so on, some elements and imagery will reappear, build immediate memories, fade, and challenge the viewer to find their own connections. While staying fragmented and open-ended, the experience will build a different visual narrative for each viewer.
Thank you.